There are lessons all around us if we take the time to listen. This is the story of two birds. It was another warm and sunny summer day. I was practicing shooting my bow and arrow in the field when I heard Grandfather's voice call me from the front of the wigwam.
"Hey, little hawk, come over here."
I ran to see what Grandfather wanted.
"Little hawk, I want you to take a walk with me. We are going up on the hill."
The hill was the South Mountain. It rose high up out of the valley. At the top was Crystal Lake. And it was so high up, we could see for miles and miles all around. As we walked toward the foothill, Grandfather was telling me why we were going to the hill.
"Little hawk, we can learn lessons from animals of how to live in a good way. We must watch and listen to them when they speak to us in their way. We are going to sit among the trees and listen to their lesson for us today."
I said, "Grandfather, you said us. You already know the good way to live."
"Yes, that's true. But grown-ups have to be reminded every so often of how to live in a good way."
We reached the brook, crossed it, and soon we were among the trees in the foothills. We walked along a narrow path, Grandfather ahead and me right behind. He stooped down to pick up a straight branch that had fallen from one of the trees. He used it as a walking stick. I found a walking stick too. It was much smaller than Grandfather's stick, but I used it just as he did. Grandfather sat down and leaned back against a big tree with his legs stretched out. He motioned to me to come over and sit next to him. I could understand everything he said when he spoke to me only with his hands. So there we sat. Grandfather's eyes were closed, so I closed mine. He was quiet, so I was quiet too. After sitting for a little while, Grandfather said,
"I want you to listen to the birds. They have a message for you today. They are going to tell you how to live in a good way. Then you are going to tell me what the birds told you. You must be very quiet. Do not move around. Close your eyes and listen only to the birds."
"Only to the birds will I listen, Grandfather," was my answer. Grandfather closed his eyes again, and so did I. Just then, I heard leaves rustling close by. I opened my eyes and saw two chipmunks chasing each other back and forth over Grandfather's legs. I was so excited, I started laughing. The chipmunks stopped, looked up at me, and ran away just as fast as they could. And that was really fast. "Grandfather, the chipmunks were playing tag across your legs and they made me laugh."
"Yes, little hawk. Animals bring joy to us, just as people bring joy to each other. Now, let us hear what the birds have to say."
"Grandfather, I will really listen." I leaned back against a tree and closed my eyes, again listening for the birds. I could hear the breeze moving the tops of the trees, and something was scampering in the underbrush. Maybe it was Grandfather's little friends, the chipmunks. That's when a bird started singing. It sounded like it was in the same tree we were leaning against. Its song was so bright and so clear that I knew it was singing its song just for me. Another bird started singing its song. Its song was just as clear and bright as the bird singing above us. I opened my eyes very slowly to see the second bird. There it was, on the bottom branch in the tree right in front of us. A beautiful yellow and black bird. When it stopped singing, the first bird in the tree above us started its song. When that bird stopped, the other started. Back and forth they sang, first one, then the other. Very slowly, I moved my head back so I could see what the bird overhead looked like. And there it sat, on the lowest branch, right over our heads. Its red and white colors were as bright and happy as its song. The two birds did not look alike. One was really little, and the other was big. One was black and yellow, the other red and white, and each had its own song. I closed my eyes again and listened as Grandfather told me to do. As soon as my eyes closed, both birds started singing their own songs at the same time. It sounded like one beautiful, happy song they had been waiting to sing together for a long time. As I listened, my heart became as happy as their song. They sang and sang, and I listened and listened. When they stopped, it was at the same time and on the same note. Quickly, I opened my eyes, but I was not quick enough. They had flown away. Grandfather said the birds would tell me something that I must learn. What did they tell me? What did I learn? Now, I must think. They were not the same colors. One had yellow and black feathers, and the other had red and white feathers. One was little, and one was big. Each had its own song, and they had sung together. Then I knew what the bird's message was to me. They told me, "You don't have to be the same kind of bird to have a happy song, and you do not have to be or look exactly the same to come together and make one beautiful song." Grandfather opened his eyes, looked at me, and smiled. He stood up and said,
"You have been very quiet, little hawk. It is in my quiet times that many answers to questions come to me. Have you had answers come to you?"
We began to walk the narrow footpath back toward the village. I was quiet. So was Grandfather. We reached the brook and crossed it in silence. We arrived at our wigwam, and Grandfather motioned to me with his hands to come and sit next to him.
"What did the birds teach you about how to live in a good way?"
I did not answer right away because I was still thinking. Then I told him of my message from the birds. He smiled, put his arm around my shoulders, and gave me a big hug. He said,
"As you grow older, you may begin to forget the things you learned today. Always remember, take time to stop, to look, and listen to your friends in the forest. They never forget. And their messages about how to live in a good way are all around us all the time."